amazing.
Everybody, it's Nebula at the Top of the Dance Party. We're back, everybody.
We were
flummoxed by the storm last week, but we're back.
Ready to rock twice as hard.
Five, sort of.
Let me introduce everybody. I am, my name is Ken, but you might know me as Sleaze Grinder. World renowned. All right. Last gang in town tomorrow. Right? America's showgirl, everybody. It's Elsa Ryan! Woo! Yeah! To my left, there she is, the Chachi to my Fonz. It's Stacey DC! And right over there, wait, are they turned? Everybody's turned.
They were over there.
Yeah! Woo! Yes! Black Leather Lagoon, the kings of the nighttime world.
Real goons.
Oh, what a show tonight. It's incredible, the show that we have tonight. All the way from Rochester, New York. Hot mayonnaise are here, everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Hot mayonnaise. Let's hear it for them.
It's here for Rochester. Woo! Oof. Know anything about that place?
6-hour drive. We're going to learn all about Rochester tonight. That's one of the many things we'll come to know tonight is Rochester, New York. Oh my God! Hey everybody, let's hear it. The gorilla's back. I am so happy that our gorilla's back.
Do a split.
What happened?
Oh my God! Incredible.
What happened is our gorilla, he was hanging out with us too much and he started failing out of school, so he had to go patch his education back together. And he did it. Now he's back. So let's hear it, everybody, for the
dance
gorilla. We
happily employed dropout.
Hey, funny lady Sterling Smith is here to give us some laughs.
Hey.
Boston's greatest ever hula hooper, Jessica Lee Scary, is here, everybody.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, my God. Very incredibly talented. And, of course, the equally incredible Saint Anique is here tonight. She's going to be doing a little number with hot mayonnaise. And by the way, Jessica Lee is going to be performing. Put all that together, and you have just an incredible evening worth of entertainment. That is.
Is there time for all
that?
That
is for. We're gonna.
We'll make it work.
We'll fit it all
we
in there.
We always do.
My mic is cutting. What is happening with my microphone? We just spent the last hour sound checking. This is an outrage. Anyway.
Somebody's fired.
Yeah, but don't worry. We'll fix it while this band plays. All right, here's what we're going to do. I had a lot to talk about, but we don't really have any time to talk about it now. What we will do is we will go right to the rock and roll because they seem like they're ready to rock already. So we don't want to keep them waiting. If you like condiment rock, everybody, and if you don't, If you don't like condiment rock, raise your hand because I want you out of this room.
Yeah. Show yourself out.
This guy. Bands
ketchup.
Bands that are involved with ketchup or mustard or relish
ketchup
or. We're gonna find out because here they are, everybody. All the way from Rochester, New York. It's Hot Mayonnaise.
To your woman, and I've been no shame. This shit's just been pretty dirty. Back as a daddy's flame. I didn't come here to be your man. Didn't come here to hold your hand. Didn't come here to tear your eyes. Dirty, they can apologize. We're getting pretty sloppy. I can't remember your name. Feeling dirty, so free. But the daddy is me. I'm making up to you. But I was doing a break. Already had a break. In the diamond ring. Making up to you. But I was doing a break. Yeah. Already had a break. In the diamond ring. Baby, hey. We'll be right back.
good time, but all the time was said. Had a real good time, but all the time was said. Had a real good time. But they all, but they all, they got a hand. They got a hand. But they got a hand. Come on.
Mayonnaise, come on over here, and we'll get to know hot mayo a little bit.
Did we figure out this mic situation?
I don't know. Did we figure out the mic situation?
How's this?
Is the mic okay? Everything's okay now.
This one's dead. Oh.
All right, come on over here, hot mayonnaise. Let's talk a little bit, because I have a lot to. I did some research on Rochester, so I could make them feel at home when they get here. Here they come. They drove all the way out here. Hey, hot Mayo, tell us about your journey to Boston. How did it go?
It was straight down the 90.
Had some Kenny Loggins. Thank you, Kenny Loggins.
Yeah, we listened to Sweet, Kenny Loggins. You know, we had some...
Highway to the Danger Zone.
Oh, dude, it was great.
We recited all of Cannonball Run. So
yeah.
Let's talk about Rochester for a minute, if we can, if you're willing.
The answer is garbage.
Oh yeah, you guys have a garbage plate.
We got White Hots and garbage plates.
Yeah, garbage plates. Shut up.
Wait, what's a garbage plate?
Tell everybody what a garbage plate is.
All right.
All right, here we go.
All right, it's mac salad, beans, home fries with two cheeseburgers, hot sauce, onions, and mustard. All on one plate.
All on one pie.
I don't know what you just said, but
yeah, it's all on one.
The sauce is like a meat hot too, so there's more beef in the hot sauce than there is. Yeah. In the
sounds like a heavy shit to me, but
yeah,
it's worth it.
Though. Over the heavy shit. It's
bit rough. And that's really the only. It's the only place you can get one, right? Is in Rochester. I never heard of it anyplace
else.
Right.
I'm gonna assume so,
from.
Man.
We haven't found it anywhere else.
Yeah. There isn't.
No, not really.
Eat enough of those things. Really? Go out of town. You see what they have.
Well, I feel like the last thing you want is a non-authentic garbage plate.
You don't want a fake garbage plate.
Yeah, cute. I think authentic
garbage. You grooming each other?
Yeah, we do that.
We clean each other.
Yeah. Well, I have to say, it's this Rochester sounds like an incredible and exotic place. There's one thing that I know about this Rochester that I wanted to ask because it's very it's very famous. Have you guys ever been to Spook Hill in Rochester?
No.
Yeah.
It's very famous based on
these guys
research.
Have never heard of it.
No, it's famous. Do we call it that there?
I don't know. Maybe you call it something different. There's a hill in Rochester where
probably the hill that you roll down on like Fourth of July.
On Spook Hill, your car will roll uphill and on Spook Hill.
Maybe it's like and a makeout point.
And your bike will. No, it's in Rochester. Go home and ask anybody, and then we'll tell you.
Spook Hill.
I can't believe you guys.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, no. Rochester.
We're not actually from Rochester.
Can we get the
Rochester
rainbow that says "The more you know"? Right
also, 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 this is what I heard. Also, the Illuminati. They are specifically supposed to have a secret sanctum below the streets of Rochester. That's
no
what
comment.
I
no comment. Yeah, okay. We don't talk. Gotta ask George Eastman about that. He's that.
All right, guys. So what do we need to know about Rochester? Come on.
Yeah.
Has garbage plates.
Hot spot.
It is a very rock-oriented city. A lot of small clubs. Bug Jar, Skylark, Photo City now.
I love it.
Rosen Crown.
Sounds good.
Yeah, a lot of small little hole in the wall pubs.
A smaller city, there's a lot going on.
Tuesdays are good nights. Tuesday night is a good night in Rochester.
Especially the last Tuesday of every month.
Really good. Is Tuesday the new Saturday in Rochester, New York? Is that what's happening?
It's the old Saturday, the new Saturday, and the Saturday.
That's when Pop Man
is. That is.
Oh,
I believe you. That is outrageous. Let's talk about the name of the band. You're called Hot Mayonnaise. Let's think about some practical applications.
BLT.
For hot mayonnaise. Yes, you got your cheesesteaks and your BLTs. What else could we use hot mayonnaise for?
Bubble bath.
Neil, you could take a bubble bath in it.
You could put it on your body.
It makes a great moisturizer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it a good moisturizer?
You know what? Yeah, no, good hair. Really mayo, good I've heard, is a great hair moisturizer.
I heard you could take.
Oh.
Really?
I think I learned that from The Simpsons.
Perfect example. Gross.
What about lubricant?
I was wondering.
I was thinking lubricant for getting into skinny jeans.
Ooh, leather jeans.
Anything. Okay. Yeah, except then you're going to smell like mayonnaise, which.
Yeah, but that's not.
To some people.
It might be better than the activity you were doing before. It depends.
Yeah. Let me ask you this. Was hot mayonnaise the first name that you chose, or were there other possibilities before you landed?
It was either that or cold creams.
Cold cream.
I love cold cream.
Okay. Yeah.
Name and what would kind of go along with it.
So first the name and
wait,
then
what's
the, band.
The what's yeah. the what's the what was gonna go along with it? What are, what else are we?
So yeah, you there, what this,
this
is
debauchery.
It, this is what goes
okay.
along with it.
All right. Yeah. Okay. All right. Oh, you weren't. Hot mayonnaise created this.
Yes. We had 9 to 5 jobs. Most of us left our families.
So honestly, if you guys had to submerge yourself in a bath of something, would it be hot mayonnaise?
Oh, I would love that.
Mine's
I think.
Ranch dressing.
Yeah.
Is that ew? Is that grosser than mayo?
Cannonball barbecue.
Gorilla says no.
We
Jenny Cream Ale.
Solid one.
We were gonna. It's a very involved story. But Stacy and I were gonna make a movie once that was gonna culminate with her taking a bath in ranch dressing. But a ranch dressing is too expensive. We can't
couldn't find a plumber. It was the whole thing. Yeah.
Yeast flour? Would flour and water, would that make it look like ranch?
It's not really. The only thing that looks like ranch is ranch. By the way, mayonnaise would work a lot better because if you heat up mayonnaise, it's just going to turn into oil. It's going to go right down the drain. But it's not
my
about
story
mayonnaise.
My story is a ranch story, yeah.
Yeah, she's
not budging.
No, she's not budging. Someday we'll have a ranch budget and then we can finally make it. Hey, so really the look, the hot mayo look, there's a lot of shirtless young dudes there. Is this what you landed on or did you experiment with other looks?
We screw around with paisley and okay. stuff like that. Well, you know,
we screw around with paisley.
We screw around with paisley. Yeah. Right. That's a thing.
You mess with paisley a little bit here and there. Yeah. Yeah. All right. What about jumpsuits? You ever think about?
We're not at that phase for us yet, I don't think.
We're still a little too sweaty for
we're
that.
Not
yeah.
Yet.
Yeah. Yeah.
Rehab clinics.
Yeah. We need
horses.
Disco
makes. Adidas.
Yeah, that
we
would
could
be
do that tomorrow.
Yep, we would do that
tomorrow.
Okay. All right, if you're listening, Adidas, if you're watching, these guys want to sell out as soon as possible.
Buy in. We call it buying in.
Buy it in, not selling out.
Big opportunity.
It's buying in. Yeah, you know, honestly, a lot of young bands these days, how they get by is they get some kind of sponsorship. Seems to me that Hellman's or one of these kind of characters could get into this.
I think they
send the hot
a family
mayonnaise
message. They're a family.
They're more of a family.
Ooh.
What
yeah,
is the...
Dude, nobody likes Miracle Whip.
Yeah, I know. Is that proper
Miracle
mayonnaise?
Miracle Whip is the worst.
No.
It's disgusting. It's horrible.
Tuna?
They put sugar in their mayonnaise.
Yeah, sugary mayonnaise.
It is. That's exactly right. That's right. It's sugary mayonnaise.
I'm not convinced these guys even like mayonnaise.
I do not. Oh, it's disgusting. Bro.
Really? Oh, I'm very disappointed.
I'll eat it. Why, you got a jar?
You got a jar here?
All right. So listen, what do you... Let's put ourselves in the picture. It's a Tuesday night in Rochester because obviously that's the big night there. And hot mayonnaise is rocking. First of all, describe the audience. What does your audience look like? What kind of people are coming to the Hot Mayonnaise show?
A lot of stompers, a lot of shakers, punk rockers, a couple squares. You know, you get a healthy amount of squares.
Okay, a couple squares.
Usually
here,
everybody's today? Everybody's pretty loaded. and then it just devolves from there.
Yeah, okay. And
it devolves. Go fast.
What would you say is the... What is the optimal, what kind of audience participation are you looking for? Tell me what's good out there. Breakdancing, full-on makeout, sweat, fighting.
If you can do all three of those at once, we want you at our show.
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely.
Ooh.
That wall down one time.
Yeah, there was a guy who knocked the wall down.
Yeah, there was a guy who knocked the wall down. So that was fair. Fair fight.
But what wall did he knock down? Was it a load-bearing wall?
We played a show in Syracuse, and we were down in a basement.
Okay.
Yeah, of a house that no longer operates.
All right.
And he went through the wall that separated the green room, if you can call it that, from the stage, and just missed a couple load-bearing support beams. So that was like a good accident, a good happy accident. He is a big, very big dude.
Oh yeah. All right. Hey, we're running out of time. So there they are, everybody. Look, it's hot mayonnaise, everybody, from Rochester, New York. It's hot mayonnaise. All right, we'll hear more from hot mayonnaise later on. All right, you guys get out here.
They don't smell though.
I got too caught up. I forgot to
I thought they would smell, but they don't.
No, no. You thought they'd... Did you think that they would smell like hot
dogs? A lot of our shirtless guests do.
Yeah.
We probably do, too.
I definitely stay humble
now.
Like
we just had some rock and roll. Now it's time for laughs. That's the way we do it on this show. And this next performer is one of the fun... And I have to give her my microphone, apparently. I'll do that. It's no problem. She's one of the funniest comics in town. I don't know how we got her, but here she is, everybody. It's Sterling Smith! Woo-hoo!
Testing, 1, 2, 3. It's like a flashback. I see Mark Bolan the third. See a Led. I see where's that ZZ Top Love Child. I've got the Rejected Beach Boy. And if you were chefs, your name should be Hot Hollandaise. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been known to be intimidating, and I've been accused of being somewhat of making people uncomfortable. So if you trigger easily, I strongly suggest you cover your ears. I like my sex. Like my... I like... Oh, my God. Talk about sex. Hello. I like my stand-up like my husband likes our sex. Ready at a moment's notice. Better in front of an audience. And over before someone turns on the light. I think that women are so much better at stand-up. Because even when we suck, we'll still smile and say, thank you for coming. My husband and I have been together for quite a long time. I really don't understand why we're together. I know we're too lazy to get divorced, definitely too cheap. But I do believe the real reason is one of us is suffering from a severe case of Stockholm Syndrome. I really didn't think we'd be together this long. Isn't it amazing what happiness does for the terminally ill? It's a slow burn. You'll get it later. When I lost my virginity, well, after I woke up, I got a quiet ride to the bus stop, a half-hearted, oh God, and a nasty STD. I hear millennials get a gift card, a money shot, I mean a headshot, and an actual trophy. What I want to know is, what do the girls get? Albert. My name is Sterling. Well, that's actually my slave name. Okay, white people, you can laugh. If you said it was too soon, I was going to give you a lot of shit. I'll have you know that in the BDSM community, I am quite the submissive. My nana says that if you're good at something, it's not bragging. A submissive is one of those individuals that's usually on the bottom. And as an African-American woman, that's where I shine. If you're one of those individuals who thinks a sub is something you eat for lunch, and maybe a little more frosting on the cupcake, but it's still tasty at room temperature. A couple of years ago, I suffered from colon cancer, and I'm here to tell you that there are some optimistic things about getting cancer. One, I can now wear my skinny jeans. I don't really have to worry about camel toe, but if I cough, lack, or hiccup, I do have to worry about colon blow. Shh. It's depends. Now in thong version. I had long, long dreads before my treatment. Well, they were blonde, but in my mind. But they were really long. I was in the shower, and ladies with long hair, you know, you're squeezing it out and you're doing the herbal essence way before your time, but I'll do it anyway. Oh, oh, and when you're trying to get the water out, you squeeze it. All my dreads came out in one lump. So I went, ah! And my husband comes running into the shower, and he opens the door, and I instinctively go, oh! And he looks down, and he goes, has it been that long? I finally, after 2 years after my treatment, I got my MMD card. That's the medical marijuana dispensation card. I dare you to try and say that when you're stoned. Even more entertaining, try spelling it. I got my MMD card. I tried the government weed. I get better shit from my electrician. And he delivers in 30 minutes or less, unless he's stoned. I do believe that's my time. My name is Sterling. Thank you for listening.
Sterling Smith, everybody! Yeah. Sterling, come on over here. Let's hang out. Sterling, thank you for being here. Wow, there's a lot. There's really a lot to work with there. What do you want to start with, Stacey? There's a lot.
I don't know what to talk about. I'm really relating to Stockholm syndrome right now, but I want to hear more about the cancer.
Cancer?
Yeah, yes. Let's talk about cancer.
It was very painful.
Fun one.
But it was that, a very that makes good, sense. It was a very good learning. A great story. I'm Is really into story? Science. Yes, okay. I am. So I took pictures of what my ass looked like.
Yeah.
It wasn't. I haven't looked at them yet, but I was taking the picture and I had my iPhone bent over. You know, ladies like our bodies ourselves, checking out the junk.
Yeah.
As you must.
And I was, not only was I exhausted, but I was so dizzy that I passed out. My sister runs up to find me, and I'm with my phone, with my pants around my ankles.
This was after the surgery?
This was after
Wait,
the, all
so
the
you
treatment.
Wanted to, you wanted to see how
I wanted
it, documented. Looked afterwards. Okay.
Believe you me, I look like a baboon in heat.
Yeah.
Okay. Ken, have you ever looked at your butthole?
I've never. I have no idea what my butthole looks like.
Get your like iPhone science. Out and take a picture. It's for science.
Yeah. Why wouldn't you be curious?
Have you taken a picture?
Oh,
of yours?
I take regular.
Really?
No,
I don't take pictures, but
we look.
I look at the front and the back.
We look.
How would you even?
Sometimes I want to know if it's getting any bigger.
Wait, is it like, are you doing like a?
Getting any
yeah,
bigger?
Yeah, it's like a preference.
Are you doing
sometimes.
Like a? Are you doing like a mirror thing? What is
yeah,
happening?
I have a mirror.
Girls look. Guys don't.
Is Weird. That how you, I mean...
They don't look unless it's something big.
Oh, yeah. Them and right.
Them. Yeah, to be fair, I never want to see any.
I'm with
Except
you.
Except a baby.
You.
That's because you're bubble. Wiping. Baby. They're so cute in there. Yeah. Wiping. Cleaning. Clean buttholes.
Yeah.
I also want to know, are you really into
PSA.
BDSM? Are you into BDSM?
When you've been married as long as I have.
You get into it.
You...
So sure
you do whatever you can.
Wait a minute. How?
That's right. You can do whatever you can to keep love alive, ladies and gentlemen. Do whatever you can.
So
get the whips, the chains,
before...
whatever.
Wait a minute.
How long into marriage are you like?
Yeah, exactly.
What can we do to salvage the...
Yeah, how long have you been married?
30.
Okay, all right, 30. Whoa. I've only been married 17, so I'm not at the BDM.
You're at
BDSM.
The halfway point.
Yeah, I'm at the halfway point.
Is it coming soon?
Yeah, tell me how long I've got left.
It's coming soon to a bedroom near you.
Okay, all right. Then you got to figure out...
How do you work into it? What I want to know is, how do you initiate the conversation, or have you always been?
Oh, I've always.
Okay.
Exploratory. Yes, that's it. I take pictures of my ass during chemo treatment.
Yeah.
Once that's done, you can do anything you want, ladies and gentlemen. Take pictures and then move on. It's for science. My science.
Yeah.
I have a file so that when I get old and I touch it, it says physical fitness and stuff like that, so people can look and go, this is what she was like.
That would be really, like, imagine, like, that data, like, outlives mankind and then aliens. Like,
yeah, what the hell is that?
Yeah.
It looks like an ass. I don't know. It's like a kumquat.
Fascinating glimpse into the human experience.
The human body is an amazing thing. Constantly amazed at what it can do.
You're living proof of that. That's mm-hmm. for sure.
You are so right. Thank you.
So romantically, a submissive. But how about if you ever you're at the restaurant, you don't like what you get, you ever return it?
Yes.
Okay. All
I'm
right.
a chef too.
So, okay, really? Mm-hmm. Okay.
All I right. do a lot of things.
All right. So you're very versatile.
I am. I am a renaissance.
So you like
21st
to cook?
Century. Today I made chicken enchiladas with black beans and rice.
Incredible.
Nice. When?
I'm a personal chef in Winchester.
Oh, nice.
I love to bake, too. And then I get baked, and then I eat my baked.
Would you be interested in coming on the Heavy Leather Show as a chef?
Yeah, sure.
Certainly. I was going to bring you some cookies, and then
God, that would have been so lovely.
Because I heard you talking about the
Ken, what do you need
tacos.
To learn to cook? I feel like you could learn a few.
Oh, I don't know anything in the kitchen, so really anything would be.
Some cooking basic.
Yeah, no, I was mentioning in the green room there that Stacey just had some tacos before the show, which I said was very I feel like millennials like tacos. Now, it was pointed out.
Confirmed.
It was pointed out that of course Mexicans have been eating tacos for thousands of years, so it's not a new thing or anything. Like they, you know, you didn't eat tacos, but you're fond of tacos.
They consume them.
I like the price point.
Yes.
$1 taco. Yeah. That's a pretty damn good deal.
Yeah. It's either like for tacos, it's either like extremely cheap or extremely overpriced.
Right.
There's no like middle of the pack taco.
$2.50.
Yeah. And the overpriced ones are ridiculous because there's nothing much more in them than
exactly,
the cheap
same
ones,
size,
ridiculous.
Same shit.
Same stuff.
Sorry.
What we try to do here on the show, Sterling, when we have comedians on, we're always trying to get a little bit further into the world, the murky world of comedy. What that's like.
The murky world of comedy.
So is there something, do you think there's something about the world of comedy that we don't know? Are there any secrets that you're willing to spill?
I'm not like most.
You started out as doing improv, right? And then you switched to stand up?
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Are you a traitor?
Yeah.
I'm not a traitor. I still do improv. I'm still
you do
an
both?
Improv group. Yep.
In and out. Boom. Little improv, little stand up.
Got to keep things going.
I figured that they would be two different worlds,
they
honestly.
Are. And this comedy world is much better. The stand-up world is much better.
Yeah, because they're
just
separate
me,
worlds.
And there's nobody else to blame but me if I...
Okay, yeah. Oh, you're saying because in the improv world, you
me
are relying on other people.
Yes.
Here's what I like about stand-up is that you write a bunch of jokes, and then if it works, you can just keep doing those jokes forever.
That's correct.
You just got to find new people to do it for. Mm-hmm. Improv, you got to be funny in a different way every single time. It's
or
too much.
Not.
And the funny
everyone
thing
else
is
dragging you down.
And here's the other thing, too.
You're absolutely
you handle
right.
it.
Imagine being the funniest person on an improv troupe.
Right. And also,
I believe it.
Yeah. Now, some of the greatest comedy that I've ever seen has been improv, like Curb Your Enthusiasm, for example, or Spinal Tap. Do you think that that's what you're going to get when you go to see improv? But it never is, because it's like, hey, somebody, name an animal, frog, name a place, dentist office, and then it's like 10 minutes of
that's
a frog
like
at a dentist
one
office.
Improv. That's Larry David improv. It's the whole
yeah,
other
they're
ball
professionals.
Game.
There's all sorts of things out there.
That's
don't
why
be jaded and don't jade your audience. Go see an improv show.
Where
you'll
should
love
we go
it or
to
hate it.
Good improv
yeah,
show.
Tell us.
Improv
please,
Asylum,
tell me where
Improv
to...
Boston.
Yeah, Improv
that's
Boston.
About it. There's two.
What are the hot clubs for comedy? Any new clubs?
Go to Underbones on Tuesday in Davis Square. It's the best place to see comedy now. And they've got and it's free, and it's on Tuesdays. In at 10, in at 9, out by 11 to watch Conan, and then go to bed. That's
oh, nice. That's beautiful. I like to be home by 11 o'clock. I appreciate that.
Because we're old.
Yeah, absolutely.
Some of us are old.
A couple of us are old.
Chronologically.
I keep a lot of young people around because then it makes me feel young.
Forever
I don't even
young.
Notice. Like, you know, suddenly, what's going to happen to me is I'm going to have a heart attack, and I go, what is this? I'm not old enough to have a heart attack.
We
no,
won't
be
let
dead.
You know.
It'll be fine.
No, did you know that 27 to 30% of people who have heart attacks don't even know they have
one? I could be having one right now.
That's right.
I hope I'm not, but I could be.
Thank God for makeup.
Any one of us could be. There she is, everybody. Sterling Smith. There she goes.
When do you want this?
She'll take it. We'll find out where we can find Sterling in just a little bit. Because, of course, we just gave you a taste of Sterling. And, of course, now you want a feast. You want to feast on Sterling, and she's going to tell you where to do that. But first, I am very excited for this next performer. I honestly think she's one of the most talented performers in town.
Co-signed.
And just incredibly talented.
Notarized.
And she's performing tonight with one of the hottest bands in town. It's really it's a match made in heaven. Here they are, everybody. It's Jessica Lee Scary and the Black Lagoon!
Oh,
Scanlon, the Black Lagoon!
What do you say?
Jessica, if you would, please come join us and we can talk about everything that just happened.
What? How do we even start?
It's an amazing feat of acrobatics and choreography and oh my god. Hi Jessica, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. This is badass.
Hey, did you used to work at King Richard's Fair?
I did work at King Richard's Fair.
Oh my god.
Doing exactly that.
Yeah, what did you do there?
Nobody from there watches this, right?
No, I don't think so.
They couldn't afford to have me fire spin. And they're like, so on your business card, we couldn't help but notice that you're a mermaid.
Okay.
Yeah, but we're here to talk about fire spinning and hula hooping and acrobats. And they're like, but on your business card, you're a mermaid.
Right.
So I got hired to be a mermaid for little kids.
Wait a minute, what does the mermaid have to do with the goddamn medieval times, though?
I have no idea, and that's eventually why they didn't ask me back. They kept picking on my set pieces, and at one point they were like, can you deflate your giant seashell?
What? That seems but like...
It's a giant clam. It's my giant clam. Try saying really that to your boss.
Were you supposed
like,
to...
It's not historically accurate.
Right.
What?
I'm like,
but who are they to tell you what to do with your giant clam?
Yeah. I'm a mythical creature.
That's exactly right.
I'm boycotting them.
And I went and we'd never go back because man, were those what did
oh, the
we
turkey
have?
Legs?
The turkey legs were so salty.
Oh my god.
How is it? It's like a mutton.
Is it like too salty? Is that
I don't know. We couldn't even really figure
it was
out.
Disgusting.
And Stacy had this incredibly cockamamie conspiracy that it was ham pressed on a fake bone. She was really convinced.
I'm sticking to it. It tastes exactly like ham.
They're artificially enhanced turkey legs. I'm pretty
but
sure
they are,
they like
it is turkey.
It starts as a turkey leg and then they soak it so it gets bigger.
Oh really?
They, like put it in salt
sodium.
To preserve
wow, that's
it's also brining. That's a legit cooking technique.
Okay. Yeah, they're almost pickled.
Well, when you put it like that.
But we went there for the cleavage contest. You remember that?
Which was incredible.
It was incredible. I feel though
it's actually one of their busiest days.
I would imagine
it was busy.
This was a couple years back, and I feel like now in the world we live in that we can't even. I don't think we can even go to a cleavage contest now. I don't think.
Well, they balanced it out. They started out. They have a hunky Celts and kilts competition as
okay,
well.
All right,
but nobody goes
ooh,
to that.
Wait,
I would go to that.
Yeah,
would you go to that?
I had fun because my little area. I'm a mermaid when I do that, so obviously I can't really walk around. But my little stage is next to that, like the costume contest, like the Game of Thrones costume contest happens there, and the kilt judging and the jugs judging.
Jugs judge.
What is the number one hoop related injury, you think? What do people do wrong when they're pooping?
I don't know. I've had a lot of injuries actually. Yeah.
While hooping.
Okay.
Charlie horses might happen.
Could be a lot
I've pulled
of, yeah.
muscles.
Yeah.
I've popped doing the shoulder stand, I've actually popped my arm out of its socket.
You ever get dizzy?
Yeah. Okay. Not as dizzy as most people, I'm told. It's a trick. There's a trick. I don't want to tell you on TV.
Yeah, don't tell me on TV.
I wouldn't presume to ask.
How do you know when your arm is out of the socket? Is it pretty obvious?
It's pretty obvious.
And then how do you get it back in there?
I go into a full-fledged panic response.
That's
number
one.
And I put it back myself.
Put it back yourself.
The first time it happened, actually, the first time I dislocated something, I dislocated my patella, and I slipped my patella totally over my tibia. So I learned how to wear my kneecap sideways, and
sounds stylish.
I freaked out and I rolled around screaming in pain and nobody came to my aid. And somehow, I couldn't tell you how I did it, I snapped it back into place.
Incredible.
And I was just literally rolling around in agony and it happened to back where it was. I can't eat raw broccoli anymore.
Whoa.
Wait, what?
Because of that sound. That's the sound it makes.
Oh, okay. All right. Good. All right. Yeah.
But when I went to the emergency room the next day, when people were finally like, you did what? You need to see someone. So I went to see someone and there was 8 people there waiting to hold me down to put my kneecap back. They're like, you did it yourself? What's wrong with you?
I remember.
Like the same thing that happens with IUDs.
Oh, God.
This is a good interview. I remember when I a few years back, I broke my arm lifting weights at the gym. And I broke it, And then I remember the guy said to me, "No, no, you just—it's just out of—you just knocked it out of the socket. You just got to push it back in."
The guy at the gym, the meathead.
He made it worse.
He's like, "I would do it for you, but I don't want to get sued. But you can just pop it back in." And I was like, "You cannot pop this back in."
You really did learn your lesson, though. You didn't break anything since then, which was—it's fairly shocking.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Exactly. Let me ask you this: we're running out of time. So, but Jessica, we're gonna have you have you back soon because I've got a lot to unpack with you. But is there a hula hooping stunt that is so, like, remember in the Tonya Harding movie, they're like, she did the triple axel. No one else would ever do the triple axel. Is there a hula hoop version of the triple axel?
Definitely. The only problem with hula hoop tricks and a lot of flow arts, the names for the moves are like names for weed. They change regionally and they don't always matter very much.
Right.
But there is a trick called the box or the frame, which is four hula hoops. And it took me almost 10 years to learn.
Wow. But it's like the one on every limb.
Yeah, when you have a hula hoop on every limb.
Oh yeah, she kills it.
Sounds like your dream to me,
the best hula hoop ever.
I just started a new one where I do the helicopter, where I do two on my top hand and then one on.
Oh my god, it's incredible! All right, Jessica, you
real professional and badass.
You stay here. What we're gonna do now is we got a little bit more rock and roll with Hot Mayonnaise, but as a special bonus, not only are we gonna see Hot Mayonnaise, we're also going to see the incredible Saint Anique.
Woo! No way! Yeah. Woo! Woo!
No. We'll be right back. It's the Hot Mayonnaise Band. Wow, that is just something else. All right, everybody.
Once again, I'm floored.
Yeah, I know. This has been a very exciting evening, but it's that time. It's the time of the show where we get everybody together and everybody does their plugs.
I've got to see this off-brand mayonnaise up close, though.
That was so exciting. I'm so sweaty now.
Saint Annie, come on over here. By the way, she just got her car back. Good for her.
Just show it
got
close up to the camera. Right, what brand are we working with?
She got the...
Nah, right, but I feel like
show.
We should.
All right. Stop and shop, everybody.
Stop and shop brand mayonnaise.
Oh, all right, get everybody over there. Hot mayonnaise, get over there. Sterling, you get over there, too, and we'll find out everything that there is find out about these people and where we can find them in the future, because of course you're going to want to see more of them. By the way, before we get to the plugs, let me just tell you that next week on this show, disco diva S the Supplicant will be here all the way from New York City. Funny man Mark Gallagher will be here. Boylesque champ Manny Emanuel will be here. And belly dancer Kathleen Laughlin. It's going to be a jam-packed show just like tonight, and that's all next week. But for now, let's get to... Stacey, you know how to do it. You know how to put microphones in people's faces.
Oh, my God.
Let's find out first the incredible Jessica Lee Scarry. Where are we going to find her next?
Oh, God. I should know that.
Yeah, that's...
Oh, yeah. I've got... in the spring, I get really nerdy, so I'm doing all sorts of nerd shows. I'm doing Serenities at the Rockwell, and I'll be doing Potter Prom at the Oberon. The Serenities is April 12th, and Potter Prom is June 17th and June 21st.
That's fantastic. Elsa, don't hog Jessica's plugs.
It's
own.
Okay. It's our.
It's our. Yeah. Yeah.
Saint Anique. You got it, right? Saint Anique.
Got it.
You got it. And now where we should find her.
So I'll be over at Houseboy in Cambridge on April 4th.
What is Houseboy?
Houseboy is like a dance party for people. It's like a queer gender dance party. Everyone's welcome. you can also catch me April 12th at Workwitch at Opus Underground. It's the new drag and gay night over there. And I'm hosting Machine Friday on April 15th.
Woo. Wow, fantastic. I don't know what a lot of that is, but I'm willing to check it all out.
Houseboy is not.
No.
Unless someone lives in the basement of the club.
The club. Okay. People might want to know.
I think it's house music is what's going on there.
Where's the club?
It's Middlesex Lounge.
Oh,
now.
Cool.
Yeah, it used
used to go to the middle.
I wouldn't know anything about queer dance.
Yeah.
let's go over to the incredible Hot Mayonnaise, who really put on a fantastic show tonight. You're going to want to catch more of them. Let's find out where we do that.
We'll be at Lux Lounge this Friday night in Rochester.
Following Tuesday, we'll be bartendering.
Bartendering.
We'll be bartendering like somewhere. Bartender. Yeah, we were good at that. And that'll be over at Bug Jar.
Yep,
and then April something or other, we're in Buffalo.
Fantastic. Yeah. That's the place to be in April, everybody. Buffalo, New York.
No, Rochester, man.
Yeah. and you can...
Stay away from Buffalo.
Stay away from there, man.
That April date was.
Right. And you can hear Hot Mayonnaise on Bandcamp. Hotmayonnaise.bandcamp. And on Spotify. All right.
There she is.
Oh, there's Sterling. Sterling, we were here vamping, waiting for you to come back so you can tell us where we can find
Sterlingstandsup.com. Sterling. I have a little thing called the C word. It's all about my kids. But it's fun things, too. That's all.
Thank you. Thank you there. Stay a little cancer and a little fun. Put it all together. Elsa Wright, right there.
Yes, the next Smoke and Shadows, my burlesque and variety show that defies decade and genre, is on Monday, April 2nd. Also, Serenities, Firefly Burlesque on Thursday, April 12th. And I also want to shout out the Good Witch Clothing, who made this awesome circusy go-go set. The Good Witch Clothing on Etsy. It's really well made, and I love it. And you'll look just as good wearing it as me. That's a guarantee.
Fantastic. Over there, it's Black Little Lagoon, and they have, of course, the Gala US is over there. Radium Girls, they got the shows coming up, so check them out. Right? Right? Yeah? Okay, good. All right. This is it. This is the end of the show. This is the part of the show where we dance. And if you don't dance, you just look really awkward. So it's really up to you to decide what you want to do for the next 3.5 minutes. But until next time, everybody. Thank you for being here. And there they are, the kings of the nighttime world. It's the Black Leather Lagoon! Yeah!